योटे क्रिगर की जेसन। पर्सन इन दिस पिक्चर इज अब्राहम लिंकन, वो वॉज यूएस प्रेसिडेंट एंड ही वॉज सफरिंग फ्रॉम मार्फन सिंड्रोम एंड ड्यू टू दिस मार्फन सिंड्रोम ही हैज योटिक रिगर्टेशन, ही हैड जुगलर आर्टेरियल प्रिसिशन वॉज विजिबल एंड ही हैड डिमस्टेड साइन नॉडिंग ऑफ हेड। दो दिस मार्फन सिंड्रोम वॉज डिस्क्राइब 30 years आफ्टर हिज डेथ। इटियोलॉजी, एओटिक रेगुलेटेशन, रूमेटिक हार्ट डिजीज इन डेवलपिंग कंट्रीज, दिस इज एओटिक रेगुलेटेशन इज यूजुअली ड्यू टू रूमेटिक हार्ट डिजीज एंड इट्स नॉट आइसोलेटेड रीजन, इट्स यूजुअली एसोसिएटेड विद मिट्रल वॉल्व लीजन, ट्रकस्पिड वॉल्व लीजन और पल्मोनरी वॉल्व लीजन, इट्स नेवर आइसोलेटेड। दिस एओर्टिक रीगर्टेशन मे बी कॉन्जेनाइटल, मे बी ड्यू टू इन्फेक्टिव इंडोकार्डाइटिस और ड्यू टू ट्रॉमा, दीज आर प्राइमरी कॉजेज ऑफ एओर्टिक रीगर्टेशन, दीज आर रिलेटेड विद द वॉल्व्स एंड समटाइम्स ड्यू टू एओर्टिक रूट डायलेटेशन, दिस रूट विल गेट डायलेटेड एंड देर विल बी लीक फ्रॉम दिस एओर्टिक वॉल्व बिकॉज दे आर नॉट अप्रोक्सीमेटिंग and so there will be leak and this will be due to aortic root dilatation in ankylosing spondylitis, SLE, Marfan syndrome, Ehlers-Danlos syndrome, hypertension, aortic dissection and aortitis. Hemodynamics, see normally what happens, blood comes to left atrium and from left atrium to left ventricle and from left ventricle blood will go to aorta and it will not come back. This left ventricular blood will not go again to left atrium or this aortic blood should not come to left ventricle during the diastole. But what happens in aortic regurgitation? This wall becomes regurgitant due to fibrosis. This wall becomes regurgitant and blood from aorta will come to left ventricle. You can see left ventricle is receiving blood from two sources, from left atrium and from aorta. So this left ventricle is huge in size. It enlarged and there is hypertrophy in wall of the left ventricle. And because this aortic blood is coming during diastole, so there will be a diastolic murmur. And during systole of aorta, extra blood, systolic volume will be very high, so there can be a murmur, ejection systolic murmur in aortic area. And tachycardia is well tolerated in aortic regurgitated patients. If suppose you give some drug and heart rate gets reduced, so what will happen? This diastolic time will increase and aortic blood will get more time to regurgitate to left ventricle. So left ventricular volume will increase. So you should not promote bradycardia in aortic regurgitated patients. Tachycardia is favorable, so that this blood can get less time for regurgitation. So tachycardia is always favorable. Clinical features: mild to moderate AR, no symptoms, but in severe AR, patient may have palpitation, exertional dyspnea, angina, and paroxysmal nocturnal dyspnea. And these signs: water hemorrhage, Corrigan sign, Quincke's pulse, and Demested sign. These signs are due to increase in pulse pressure. Pulse pressure is blood pressure during systole minus blood pressure in diastole is pulse pressure. So you see there is wide pulse pressure in aortic regurgitation patient. Systolic volume is larger, so systolic pressure will be higher and during diastole blood is going to periphery and blood is coming back to left ventricle. So diastolic pressure will be less and systolic pressure will be high. So there is, these signs are due to wide pulse pressure, and there it will be water hammer pulse. Water hammer pulse is blood is hitting arterial wall like hammer, and blood is mainly water. So blood is hitting arterial wall like hammer. So it will be so it's called water hammer pulse, and it will be it will rapidly rise and it will suddenly collapse. Water hammer pulse will rapidly rise due to extra systolic volume. It will rapidly rise. Systolic volume is more, so systolic pressure will high is high, and it will rapidly and output is mainly in initial period of systole. So during initial period of systole, systolic pressure is very high, so it will rapidly rise. This pressure will aortic pressure will rapidly rise, and peripheral pulses also, it will peripheral pulses also will rapidly rise, and during diastole there is backward flow and forward flow, flow of blood in two directions. So it will suddenly collapse. So it's called water hammer pulse, and it's due to hyperdynamic circulation. And this diastolic pressure, sometimes this diastolic pressure may be zero also. And Corrigan sign, prominent carotid pulsation due to increase in systolic volume during early systole. So early systole, carotid pulsation will be visible. This is called Corrigan sign. We can see aortic pulsation will also be visible, and in extremities arterial pulsation will be visible. This is called Corrigan sign. Punkeys pulse, if we examine nail bed of the patient, capillaries of nail bed of the patient, it will repeatedly blur and blanch. This is called Punkeys pulse. This is due to aortic regurgitation and wide pulse pressure. Demerset sign, nodding of head with each systole. Systolic blood volume is very high, so there will be nodding of head. And this, the Demerset sign was present in, people say, it was present in Abraham Lincoln's case. Hill sign, there will be a difference in pressure between brachial artery and femoral arteries. Normal difference of pressure between brachial and femoral artery is 20 mmHg. Femoral arterial pressure will be higher, so normal difference is 20 mmHg, and if it exceeds 20 mmHg, this is called Hill sign positive, and 20 to 40 mmHg is seen in mild patients, mild aortic regurgitation patient, 40 to 60 in moderate, and more than 60 mmHg pressure difference is seen in severe aortic regurgitation. We may hear pistol shot sound. You extra volume from left ventricle will hit arterial wall, and it will produce sound, and this is called pistol shot sound in brachial or femoral arteries with a stethoscope. Dorigeage sign, systolic and diastolic murmur over brachial and femoral artery on applying pressure over the artery. If you apply pressure with a stethoscope, we may hear systolic and diastolic murmur, and this is called Dorigeage sign. Apex will be down and out, because there usually apex is in fifth intercostal space in midclavicular line, but it will shift down and out because there is enlargement of the ventricle and hypertrophy. So it will be heaving type and it will go down and out. S1 sound usually produced by tricuspid and mitral wall. It will be soft. You see, there is dilatation of in annulus of the mitral wall. So there may be S1 will be softer, and A2 may not be heard. This A2 may not be heard due to murmur, and there will be a murmur. There will be a murmur during diastole of the heartbeat due to regurgitant blood, and this murmur will be heard in third or fourth intercostal space left of parasternum, and it will radiate to the apex, and this murmur will be better heard by diaphragm of the stethoscope and patient leaning forward. You see, this is decrescendo murmur. This decrescendo murmur will be heard after S2, and you see it's decrescendo, intensity is going down. So a decrescendo murmur will be heard in aortic regurgitation patient. It will be in diastole, and due to excessive systolic volume, will pass through this aortic valve, and this aortic valve will be narrower for the volume. So there may be a ejection systolic murmur due to high systolic volume at the aortic area. We may hear second murmur. It will be during systole, and third murmur, Austin Flink murmur. It will be pre-systolic or late diastolic murmur. It will be mitral in origin, and this due to this regurgitant blood from aorta, it will hit this mitral valve, and it will produce a vibration in mitral valve, and this vibration will produce a murmur, and this murmur is called Austin Flink murmur. Investigations. X-ray chest. In X-ray chest, you will get left ventricular enlargement. See, left ventricle is very big, and aortic dilatation. This aorta will be dilated. At ECG, there will be left ventricular hypertrophy type picture, and there will be a strain, ST segment depression, and T-wave inversion. And echocardiography will give whole information. It will show left ventricular hypertrophy, dilatation, and severity of AR. Severity of this aortic regurgitation will be seen with echocardiography. Echocardiography is a revolution in diagnosis of heart diseases, and it gives almost all informations we need for management of heart diseases, especially valvular, all types of heart diseases. Complication, there may be CCF. In late cases, initially this left ventricle is dilated and hypertrophy. It will manage cardiac output, normal cardiac output, and patient will not have features or complication. But with time, this ventricle will get weaker, and there will be CCF type. This ventricle will fail, and there will be increase in left ventricular end diastolic pressure and left atrial pressure, and similarly there will be rise in pulmonary venous arterial pressure. And patient may suffer from infective endocarditis and pulmonary edema. Due to increase in pulmonary pressures, patient can have pulmonary edema. Left ventricle will fail. So initially, in left ventricular failure, patient will have paroxysmal nocturnal dyspnea, and later on, if this pressure rise further, patient can have pulmonary edema also. Management, we should give prophylaxis against rheumatic fever. It usually in our country it's usually due to rheumatic fever, so we should give prophylaxis against rheumatic fever to prevent further damage of aortic wall, tricuspid wall, and mitral wall. And treatment of infective endocarditis if it's there, and treatment of congestive heart failure. We should treat congestive heart failure if it's there. Pulmonary patient is dyspneic, patient has orthopnea, patient has paroxysmal nocturnal dyspnea or patient had pulmonary edema, we should treat congestive heart failure. And diuretics is always beneficial for the patient. It will reduce preload of the heart, and afterload reduction is also helpful. Afterload, how we reduce afterload? By using vasodilators, and there we should not use beta blockers. Beta blockers will decrease heart rate, and so it will promote regurgitation of blood from aorta to left ventricle. So we should never use beta blockers in AR patients. And final treatment is aortic valve replacement before patient gets complications. And aortic valve prosthetic, aortic valves are two types, bioprosthetic and mechanical valves, and whatever is suitable, we should replace the valve. Thank you.